How has it been to have such a positive reception from fans and viewers? I mean, picked up early on for a second season. It has to be encouraging, a little bit of a load off, I would imagine.
Big time. I mean, this project was such a, I was on Supernatural for 15 and a half years because the pandemic kind of dragged out an extra 6 months. And so this project was already in development. And so the pressure valve hadn't yet been released. It was just longer wait and longer wait and longer wait and longer wait. It gave us more time to work on it, I suppose, from afar. But the fact that people are enjoying it is a great credit to Anna Fricke and our awesome writing staff, our directors, our cast. It's a bold move, I guess, to take a show that was so popular for so long and totally reimagine it. And it can go one of two ways. Either they say, there aren't enough karate kicks to people's heads, or they go like, oh, I see, this is a different show for a different time, and embrace it. And it seems like a lot of folks have chosen the latter. And so it's great, because we're all working really hard. We take it really seriously. We have a good time on set, and as much as we can in this crazy like COVID world where we're all wearing masks. I don't know what half of our crew's faces look like unless they take down their mask to have a sip of water and put it back up. I'm like, oh, there's your face. But we're making the most of it. It already feels like we have a nice little family going on, and it's been very flattering and further kind of motivation and inspiration to keep going, keep working hard.
Yeah, I was going to mention the family dynamic here, because you all seem to gel really well as actors, as characters. What is that like behind the scenes? It's harder in COVID times. But what is that like for you guys?
You know what? We've really made the most of it. Like, we have a cast text thread. And I joke with Anna, who's running the show often. I'm like, we're talking, are your ears burning? Because we're talking about you in the cast thread. And she's like, I want to be added. I'm like, nope. We have a good time. Some of these actors I've known previously and worked with previously. And some, it was just brand new. But everybody clicks. And there's something about where we shoot here in Austin that it kind of behooves you to just be chill and be friendly. And so it's not the hustle and bustle of like a Los Angeles or even a Vancouver or a New York City. It's sort of like, hey, this is all cool. Like, if we have issues, let's just talk about them. And we were very clear since day one that, communication is key. And I think we all communicate and just get along and, tease each other and rib each other and have a good time. So that's been a nice blessing.
Nice. What has it been like for you? And you mentioned this a little at the top here about trying to take this iconic character. Yeah. And I'm not going to ask about roundhouse kicks or Chuck Norris or anything like that, but how do you adjust to that and how do you make it your own?
Yeah. Well, one of the things we would say when we were developing the show before we even shot it was this show isn't about roundhouse kicks. It's about a well-rounded family. So we just set out to tell a different story, so Chuck's Walker was about a ranger who happened to have a family. This show was really about a family man who happens to be a ranger. And so dealing with a lot of because we do that, we're more able to deal with a lot of stuff that's going on in 2021 as opposed to in 1994. It was either, hey, we're going to try and throw homages out all the time, or we're going to tell our story and see what people think. And I grew up in San Antonio, Texas. So I grew up, watching Walker, Texas Ranger with Chuck Norris, and I've seen all the memes and I love them. And so it was like, well, we're not really going to be able to recreate that. Like that stands alone in time. So what story can we tell? And fortunately for us, the studio and the network let us kind of do our bit.
Right, and that's a load off too, because you have more freedom. Let's talk real quick, because I know this airs before next week's episode. There's a cliffhanger, Clint's at the compound, there's a gunshot, we don't know what's going on. A lot of questions up in the air right now. What can you tell us?
Well, what I can tell you is that this episode that airs on next Thursday, the 10th, it was originally our season finale. So after we aired, I think episode one or two, we got picked up for season two, but they also added 5 episodes to season one. So we were going to end at 13, which is this episode, and then go to a season two, but they added 5 episodes. So this episode is enormous. Like, this was a 13 episode sell basically. And it was like, listen, episode 13 needs to be huge. And it's huge. I mean, there's action, there's emotion, everything in between. But the Rodeo King story that we've been working on all season really comes to a climax, and in a brutal and violent way. And there's a lot that goes on. We see a lot of characters that we've seen all season long so far. And everybody has an arc within, which is pretty impressive by the writers to take 42 minutes of screen time and go like, all right, we're gonna give everybody something to do. But it's wild. It's a wild episode.
I imagine, well, yeah, trying to put a bow on everything's gotta be a little tough too.
Yeah, trying to put a bow and